people describe me in many different ways. Some people call me the girl who was shot by the Taliban, and some, the girl who fought for her rights. Some people call me a noble lawyer right now. My brothers still call me that annoying, bossy sister. But as far as I know, I'm just a committed and even stubborn person who wants to see every child getting quality education, who wants to see women having equal rights. Education is one of the blessings of life and one of its necessities. That has been my experience during the 17 years of my life. In my home, I always loved learning and discovering new things. I remember when my friends and I would paint our hands with henna on special occasions. And instead of drawing flowers and patterns, we would paint our hands with mathematical equations and formulas. We had a thirst for education because our future was right there in that classroom. We would sit and learn and read together. We loved to wear neat and tidy school uniforms, and we would sit there with big dreams in our eyes. We wanted to make our parents proud and prove that we could also excel in our studies and achieve those goals. Some people think only boys can. This excerpt is from the Pakistani activist Malala Yousafzai. Let's juxtapose it with Gloria's words from the hottest movie this summer, Barbie. The resemblance in message is not only striking, it's universal. It is literally impossible to be a woman. You are so beautiful and so smart, and it kills me that you don't think you're good enough. Like, we always had to be extraordinary, but somehow we're always doing it wrong. You have to be thin, but not too thin, and you can never say you want to be thin. You have to say you want to be healthy, but also you have to be thin. You have to have money, but you can't ask other people for money because that's crass. You have to be a boss, but you can't be mean. You have to lead, but you can't squash other people's ideas. You're supposed to love being a mother, but don't talk about your kids all the damn time. You have to be a career woman, but also always be looking out for other people. Isn't it ironic that the monologue from the Barbie movie has so many parallels to the life of Malala Yousafzai, the woman who was shot by the Taliban in 2012? This program covers the Nobel Prize acceptance speech of Barbie's real-life counterpart, Malala, who has dedicated her life advocating for women's rights. When my world suddenly changed, my priorities changed too. SWAT, a place of tourism and beauty, suddenly changed into a place of terrorism. I was just 10 when more than 400 schools were destroyed. Women were flogged, people were killed, and our beautiful dreams turned into nightmares. Girls were stopped from going to school. Education went from being a right to being a crime. I had two options. One was to remain silent and then wait to be killed. The second was to speak up and then be killed. I chose the second one. I decided to speak up. The terrorists tried to stop us and attacked me and my friends on our school bus in 2012. But neither their ideas nor their bullets could defeat us. We survived. And since that day, our voices have grown louder and louder. I tell my story not because it is unique, but because it is not. It is the story of many girls. Today, I tell their stories too. I have brought with me some of my sisters from Pakistan, from Nigeria, and from Syria who share this story. My brave sisters, Shazia and Kanat, who were also shot that day in our school bus. But they have not stopped learning. And my brave sister, Kanat Sumro, who underwent severe abuse and extreme violence. Even her brother was killed. But she did not succumb. Though I appear as one girl, one person who is 5'2" tall, I am not a lone voice. I am many. I am Malala, but I am also Shazia. I am Kanat. I am Kanat Sumro. I am one of those 66 million girls who are deprived of education. And today, I am not raising my voice. It is the voice of those 66 million girls. Sometimes people like to ask me, why should girls go to school? Why is it important for them to get an education? But I think the more important question is, why shouldn't they? Why shouldn't they have this right to go to school? Dear sisters and brothers, today in half the world, we see rapid progress and development. However, there are many countries where millions still suffer from the very old problems of war, poverty, and injustice. We still see conflicts in which innocent people lose their lives and children become orphans. We see many people becoming refugees in Syria, Gaza, and Iraq. In Afghanistan, we see families being killed in suicide attacks and bomb blasts. Many children in countries like Pakistan and India are deprived of their right to education because of social taboos, or they have been forced into child marriage or child labor. One of my very good school friends, the same age as me, who had always been a bold and confident girl, dreamed of becoming a doctor. But her dream remained a dream. At the age of 12, she was forced to get married. And then soon, she had a child. She had a child when she herself was still a child, only 14. I know that she could have been a very good doctor, but she couldn't because she was a girl.